the hottest movie review on the internet today, the A-List Review. I'm your host, the Game Changer, Wes Troop. And today I'm here to review a movie that came out this past weekend. I finally got the chance to see it. I was excited when I heard this movie was coming out and saw the trailer. And then I saw a lot of people's reactions. Not so great. So I was sort of like, okay, whatever. People aren't really loving this movie, but let's see what I thought, shall we? My review of the 2018 comedy, The Happy Time Murders, coming up now. In a world where humans and puppets coexist, Phil Phillips, a private puppet detective, is on the case after a former star of the television show The Happy Time Gang is killed. It becomes even more personal as Phil's brother, who also starred in the show, is murdered. Phil teams up with his old partner, Connie Edwards, as the two try to solve the mystery before more of the cast members end up dead. So what did I think of The Happy Time Murders? I thought it's a mediocre comedy. The film has been in a long time in the making and had spent a lot of time in pre-production and had a number of stars attached to the project over the years. Because there was a lot of passion put into the film, and there are some times you can tell that, it's sad to see it wasn't a better movie. The puppeteering here is rather impressive, and I enjoyed seeing the puppets walking and thought it was well done. The comedy is very hit and miss, and unfortunately misses more than it hits. If you've seen any previews for it, you'll know it's raunchy, but there's a number of things that go over the top that really aren't needed and are just there to try to shock the audience. Some of the jokes also go on too long and get a bit tiresome after a while. I feel like the film sometimes goes astray and it goes overboard with its dirty pup gimmick, then worry about telling the story. Speaking of the story, the plot is rather predictable. We can guess pretty easily who might be behind the murders, and there's a number of mystery movie cliches, like the main character making a mistake in the past which cost him his career, or people we thought were dead being not so dead later on. Another thing that was pretty easy to figure out. There's also a racism storyline dealing with the puppets being treated as second-class citizens, which we obviously know what that's going for, but it feels a bit odd here at times. I like the main character, and actually wouldn't mind seeing him on a different case in another movie. You heard it, I wouldn't actually mind a sequel, if it's going to be better than this, at least. The cast stars Bill Beretta as Phil Phillips. No, not the singer. The ex-cop, now private investigator, trying to figure out who's knocking off the puppet stars. Melissa McCarthy as Connie Edwards, Phil's ex-partner who teams up with him once again. Maya Rudolph as Bubbles, Phil's secretary. Elizabeth Banks as Jenny, one of the stars of the show, who has a romantic past with Phil. And Joel McHale as Campbell, an overbearing FBI agent. While I like the idea of the Happy Time Murders and its premise, there are some things that work. I feel if it had toned down things a bit, reworked some jokes, and had a stronger script, it could have been more of a success. I'm gonna give it the rating of meh. You know, it's okay. All right, well that's the show. I'll be back with another review very soon. But until then, don't forget to subscribe right here on YouTube. YouTube.com/WestSideOf515. Like the show on Facebook, Facebook.com/WestTroopAList. And of course, you can follow me on the Twitter and the Instagram @WestAList. Until next time, Troop out.